Hey! Don't listen to your sister.
Hey, why didn't you think of that?
I just stopped by to see if everything was running smoothly, and I'm glad I did, because it wasn't.
How did you even get inside? There's an angry mob at the door.
You're right. I don't trust you with all my secrets.
Oh.
Oh. Oh. You know, they say holding a baby can make all these deep primal parenting instincts kick in. I don't see it.
Sonny!
Lucky! Would you like to send that log into that sock?
Yes, sir.
You think you're so superior with your fancy optometry degree and weird hypnosis thing. Well, I don't need a partner. I was better off alone, where my plots were simple and straightforward and didn't involve any high-concept science fiction gimmicks.
Are you breaking up with me again?
No, I'm breaking up with you.
Again.
You're being insensitive.
You're being in...
Don't say the word.
Inordinate.
Now he's unhypnotized. How in the world does a child know a word like inordinate?
Rats know all kind of words. They're book addicts. But there is still time to cause an accident and get their fortune.
Oh, no, you can't. Now put my sister down.
Yeah, you may have saved Charles, but there will still be a fatal accident at the lumber mill tonight. Oh, there you are.
You want our fortune, you can have it. Just leave Sonny alone.
You think you're so clever, but you only see in black and white. Just like your parents, they were short-sighted too. With their you can't hypnotize people. And what about free will? And we're going to kick you out and have your license revoked. And if we ever have children, we're never going to let you anywhere near them. Well, I showed them.
I don't think I can hold them off much longer, boss.
I'll show everyone. It's never about the fortune. It's about...
Sometimes when we are startled by a loud noise or an angry mob looking to confront their hypnotist, we take a step back. Dr. Orwell was right. There was a fatal accident at the Lucky Smells lumber mill that night.